Waterstone's Bookshops, biggest and brashest of all the new literary emporiums, have sold the equivalent of one book to every other Londoner since they sprang up 3 years ago. They've done it by keeping vast stocks, opening late into the night, and adopting hard sell techniques like champagne sales parties and piped music. Such brazen salesmanship is alien to the genteel world of books, and has led to worries that small booksellers may be forced out of business by the new giants, who will then reduce their wares to a handful of bestsellers. But Waterstones claim the opposite is true.
If you look around our shops, we have an enormous selection of classic backlist titles everywhere, and they're absolutely vital to us. That really is the bread and butter of our business. Bestsellers are lovely, but bestsellers come and go, and really it's the backlist which really feeds us at the end of the day. I'm not sure we are competing with other booksellers. I regard our shops as competing with other ways of spending disposable income, Italian restaurants, pubs, clothes shops. I think the more bookshops that open, the more books will be sold.
One of Waterstone's rivals, the giant Hammick chain, which has opened 4 new shops in 8 months, takes a more aggressive line. They predict a spate of bloody noses in the business before the bubble bursts. But it's not the small bookseller who'll be getting them, more the newcomers fighting for prime sites to mop up the profits from the lucrative new market they've helped to create. The major threat to the small shop, they say, is the prospect of VAT on books, which they predict will lead to a cut-price book war, which only the biggest will win. Rita Carter in Hammersmith for Thames News.